Hello friends, my name is Tushar and today we are going to look at the question longest common subsequence. What is this question? Given two strings, how do we find the longest common subsequence between them? So for this particular two strings, A, B, C, D, A, and F, A, C, B, C, and F, the longest common subsequence will be A, B, B, C, C, F, and F. So the length of the longest common subsequence will be 4, and the longest common subsequence will be A, B, C, and F. So the thing with subsequence is that it need not be continuous in the string. So here A, B, C, and F, and we ignored C, and above A, B, C, and F, and we ignored a couple of characters in between. So how do we find the longest common subsequence? Yes, we will use dynamic programming to solve this question. So here I have on the first row, I have the first string A, B, C, D, and A, and F. And on the first column, I have the other string A, C, B, C, and F. Second row and second column are just populated with zeros. All right. So now let's fill this matrix, and finally we will have our solution when the matrix is totally filled. So when I'm filling this particular point in the matrix, I'm asking myself, if I had a string A and A, and nothing else, what will be the longest common subsequence here? So the length of the longest common subsequence here will be 1 when I have just these two guys. So 1. Now I have string A and B and A. So if I have string A, B, and A, what is the length of the longest common subsequence here? Again of length 1. When I have string A, B, C, and A, what is the length of longest common subsequence here? Again length 1. 1. 1 and 1. So if we had string A, B, C, D, A, and F on one side and just A on the other side, the longest common subsequence there will be A. Now we'll fill for this third row, which will now include C. So here we'll have A and C on one side and A on the other side. So you'll ask yourself, if I had string A and C and A, what is the longest common subsequence here? Again, 1. Where did we get this 1 from? From the top. So what we are seeing is, if these two guys are not same, then the length of the longest common subsequence will be either max of the guy at the top or the guy on the left. In this case, this is 1, so it becomes 1. We have string AB and AC. What is the length of longest common subsequence here? Since C and B are not same, the value here will be either the max of this or this. So in this case, it's again 1. Here, we have string A, B, and C, and A and C. Now, C and C are same. So the length of longest common subsequence will be 1, because C and C are same, plus whatever the best we did between A, B, and A. So this 1. So 1 plus 1, 2. So again, if these two guys are same, so the length of the longest common subsequence will be this plus 1. And if they're not same, then the max of this or this. All right, let's fill D in the same way. So since C and D are not same, we get the value from here, so 2. 2 and 2. All right, let's move here. If you had string A, B, A, C, and B, and A, the length of the longest common subsequence will be 1, the guy from here. For now, B and B are same. So the length of the longest common subsequence will be this guy diagonally cross guy plus 1, so 2. Again, B and C are not same, so the length will be max of these two, which is 2. Here, these guys are not same, so max of these two, which is 2. 2 and 2. All right, let's move to the next row. So here, we have C and A, and they are not same, so the value from the top, 1. Here, C and B are not same, so value from max of this or this, so 2. C and C are same, so we go diagonally across, so 2 plus 1, 3. Again, when these two guys are same, we are saying is that we already know that these guys will contribute 1 to the longest common subsequence, and we'll see the best we can do without these two guys. So that is AB, ABC, which the number is here, 2. So 2 plus 1, 3. This here is not same, so max of this and this, so 3. They're not same, 3. They're not same, so 3. Let's finish the fill up the last row. So 1, 2, 3, 3, 3. Since these two guys are same, so the value will be 3 plus 1, 4. So this is the length of our, this is the length of the longest common subsequence between them. Now, if you want to find what that actual subsequence is, we'll do this. So we'll start from here and we'll see where this 4 is coming from. So this 4 is not coming from these two guys, so it got to be coming from here. So we know that F is in the answer. So we move here, 3. Where is this 3 coming from? This 3 is coming from here, so we move one step here. Where is this 3 coming from? This 3 is coming from here, so we move one here. Where is this 3 coming from? This 3 is coming from here, so we move diagonal, and whenever we move diagonal, we include that character, C. Where is this 2 coming from? This 2 is coming from here, so we'll include B. And where is this 1 coming from? Top. And where is this 1 coming from? Here, so we'll include A. Alright, so this is the final result. A, B, C, and F is our longest common subsequence, and the length is 4. How would the formula look like? Let me quickly write the formula. If input of I is equal to input one of I is equal to input two of j, then t of I j is equal to t of I minus one j minus one plus one. Else, t of I j is equal to max of t of I minus 1 j comma t of I j minus 1. If you want the full solution for this problem, go to my GitHub link, github.com/missionpieceinterview wiki. Thanks for watching this video.